She's not what you'd expect. She's tough and feisty, but gentle and tender. She makes millions and gives millions to the poor. She cries, she laughs, she teaches, she comforts. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show. This is a show that is designed to help you to succeed. And I'm not talking about the status quo of success. In fact, on this show, we like to obliterate that. There's so many facades out there about success, and there's such a simple formula on how you can become successful. I'm living proof, and you will be living proof as well. We're going to talk about a bit of a business tip that I think applies to you, whether you own the business or you work for the business. And you can even apply it into your home as well. This is something that doesn't have boundaries, let's say, that can only be used in one arena. It is something that can be used in all arenas of your life if you decide to really look at this from a position of making yourself more valuable, or making your business, or making your home life, or making yourself more valuable to your family, to your community, or into the workplace. And so we're going to talk about something that might be a little bit surprising to you. When it comes to success, it's always good to model after success. Really look at, maybe even reverse engineer a business model and say, man, what is really causing them to be so outstanding? Because the bottom line is this: if you're not doing something outstanding, especially in the business community, then you're not standing out. And we live in a very competitive world today. So one of the ways to stand out is to be outstanding in specific areas. Well, one particular area where there's a giant gaping hole, where there's a place where you can actually make more money by simply just changing this one little thing, is going to surprise you. Let me read to you this statistic. American Express did a survey recently, and they found out that 70% of the Americans said, 70% of Americans are saying that they would spend an average of 13% more for better service. Think about that. They are willing to spend 13% more for better service. That's you and me. We all have stories of terrible customer service. Oh boy, could we talk about that, especially airlines. Oy, oy, oy. There's some airlines with some terrible service, and then there's some other airlines that have great service. Good service causes your reputation to fly. It does. It takes off all the boundaries off of your reputation when you provide good service. On the flip side of that, when you're not producing good service, and again, that's as an employee to your employer, that's as an employee to your coworkers and the customer. You can provide good service in the home as a spouse, as a caregiver. You can provide good service at your church. Those that provide good service are those who really excel. And those that produce service that's not even worth looking at, is not worth mentioning, well, obviously that's not doing anything outstanding and nothing happens for you in that case. But when you produce bad service, companies can go out of business because of bad service. Now, let's continue on in the survey. The same survey found that 60% of Americans believe businesses are not increasing their focus on good service. 26% of those believe that companies are actually paying less attention to service. It doesn't matter if you have a product or a service, or you yourself is the product or the service. People are not loyal to products. They are loyal to people. And this is where you've got to learn how to build great relationships with those that you work with, including the customers of the business that you represent. And as you extend great service, great relationship with them, people become loyal to your brand. They will use your product because of you. They use a product and service because of the kind of treatment that they're getting from the perceived other human being, even online. Amazon.com and Zappos.com are two places that I probably do majority of my gift shopping, meaning I got 5 kids and 7 grandkids. Everyone's always having a birthday at some point. There's like a couple months out of the year that someone in the family, meaning my main family unit, isn't having some kind of a birthday. And then, of course, there's the extension, you know, my close friends or other relatives that someone's having a birthday. But Amazon.com and Zappos.com have something really profoundly in common that caused me to come back and shop with them again and again and again. And what it is their service. They have figured out a way to make me enjoy the shopping experience with them. And it's on how simple they make it for me to find what I need, how quickly I can do it, how quickly I can be in and out of that cart experience. And if something's wrong, how very quickly I can get the answers with great service and not a hard time trying to solve a problem. Sometimes I can solve the problem online, but absolutely 100%, there's an 800 number with a really nice person on the other end that makes me feel like I am their best friend. And because of that, that causes me want to stay with them. I've been doing business with Zappos.com since the very beginning of Zappos.com, back when they only sold shoes. Goes to show you. Anyway, I probably shouldn't have been there all those years ago. Anyway, so we're talking about good customer service experiences as well as some bad ones so that you and I can learn and improve our game daily, because sometimes we can be producing bad service and not even realize that we're doing it. Bottom line is if you make the customer mad, the customer's going to go some other place. If you make the processes harder for the customer, they're going to go some other place to do business. And sometimes we do that without even realizing it. So I hope today's show is going to help to point out some things where you'll be able to improve your game, both at home and at work. So we're going to go to the phones, and we've got some people that are calling in to share some good customer service experiences and or some not so good ones so that we can all learn from it. So we've got Jenny McHugh from South Dakota. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, Dani.
Hi. So what are you going to share, good customer service experience or a bad one?
I don't want to focus on the bad, but I will share my bad one just because it...
They're great learning experiences. They really, really are. Yeah. So go ahead and let it fire away.
About a little over 2 years ago, we had a cable company, and I signed a contract with them. It was a 2-year contract. They had, you know, at the time they had good customer service. Everything was really good. 2 years had passed, and we looked into getting something that was cheaper. And I called the company and I asked, I did this 3 times, all back to back. I talked to an individual, asked them if we were still in the contract. They told me no. Mm-hmm. I hung up, called back, talked to a different individual. They told me no. That happened 3 times. So then when we found a different company and signed contract with, or not contract with them, but signed up with them, mm-hmm. I called Dish back after it was already hooked up and everything and canceled our service. Mm-hmm. And the lady at that time had told me that we were in a contract and we were going to be penalized. It was $287 for breaking contract. I politely explained to her that, you know, I talked to 3 people. They all told me we were not in contract. I had, when we started, the service date and everything, and she argued with me. And so I was transferred to several different people. Nobody could answer my question. Nobody could give me, you know, any information. All it was you broke contract, you're going to pay this fee. Wow. That went on for about a month. And then I got a bill from a collection company in the mail, and I called Dish back, and I talked to them about it, and the lady told me that I needed to just pay the bill, pretty much. So to get it off my credit and to, you know, be done with it, I paid the bill. And then about a year and a half passed, and actually this last January 16th, I pulled up my credit because I checked my credit weekly, and I noticed that there was another collection on there. So I looked more into it, and it was Dish Network again. And I called Dish immediately. That time, this one took 3 weeks to resolve.
Oh, my gosh.
And I was transferred probably over 50 different times in that whole 3 weeks.
Oh, my gosh.
I left message after message. Nobody returned my calls. I had to go to the extremes of getting my attorney involved because they wanted another $287. I had my bank statement that proved that I paid it already. It was already taken care of. And I had a letter from that previous collection agency that said it was paid.
That's exasperating. And
what's that?
That's exasperating.
It was. It was really time-consuming. It was frustrating. People don't understand that, you know, when a collection goes on your credit report, mm-hmm. that can hinder you from a lot of things. And I watch it really close. It took me talking to...
And this is Dish Network.
What's that?
This is Dish Network.
Yes.
Wow.
The last lady I spoke to had told me that there was nothing they could do about it. I needed to contact my cell phone company, I started laughing. And she says that they'll take care of it for you. I said, Verizon Wireless has absolutely nothing to do with Dish Network. You know, I mean, that's common sense. And she says, well, I'm going to have to let you go now.
Oh, my God.
That's when I asked to speak to the president of Dish Network. And I was transferred over. I had to leave a message. And the president had called me back within 20 minutes. And I talked to her, and she asked to have me fax all my documentation, and because I keep complete records.
Yeah.
And I faxed everything to her, and she called me back the next day and apologized greatly for everything I was put through. She told me it was taken care of. It was going to be deleted off my credit report. And so then I waited another 2 weeks, checked my credit again, and it was still on there.
Oh, my God.
So I went through the process, and I actually had her direct number, so I called her directly. And that very day, it was taken off of my credit. Everything was done. But almost 2 years of dealing with that.
And all she did was remove it from your credit?
Yeah. That's
final it.
Person just removed it out of the system. And
well, look, check this out. There we go. From the top down, you call, you get a hold of the president of the company, you tell her all of this stuff, that you've been battling all this stuff for two straight years, and her only answer is, I'll remove it from your credit? She should have given you a year free of Dish Network. She should have given you a refund for that charge of $287 that you should have never been charged for because the original three people that you asked told you were not in contract.
Yep,
so it goes to show you that if she's the best service that Dish Network has, that trickles down. And now you see why the people that you talked to on the phone that were arguing with you and doing all of this stuff and not doing their job, you can see clearly because she doesn't care about service. And it's clear. Wow. Wow. That is unbelievable. Okay, listen, when we continue back from the break, we're going to dissect this thing because you might have a policy inside of your business that's doing the same exact thing to people. It's got to come from the top down. You got to give good service, not bad service. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
Be sure to tell a friend about the Dani Johnson Show. It just might be the key to the breakthrough they need. Stay right here for more of The Dani Johnson Show.
Friend, you know me. You know how passionate I am about my faith and the land of Israel. I'm so excited to tell you about something directly from the Holy Land. A good friend in Israel has teamed up with a good friend here in the U.S. to bring an incredible product that harnesses the healing power of the Dead Sea. Have you heard about Mud Zero? Face it, we may not like to talk about it, but some of us need help with removing unwanted hair, especially in unwanted places. Mud Zero is a solution for all skin types for men and women. Rub the mask on your skin, let it sit for 5 minutes, wipe it off, and you have smooth skin without the irritation. Then follow it up with a Depi lotion daily to reduce hair growth by up to 50%. Best of all, you can feel good knowing that over 10% of the profits goes directly to King's Ransom to feed the orphan and the widow. Go right now to mudzero.com and take advantage of an introductory offer they've created just for us. mudzero.com. Imagine living in a decrepit, unsafe hovel made of waste material on top of old mining tunnels that could explode and sink your home at any moment. Imagine no water to drink, no safe place to raise your children, no food for your starving baby. Imagine that your kids can't learn to read because they have to work to support the family instead of going to school. Could you imagine living in that kind of fear and hopelessness? This is exactly what families are dealing with in the poverty-stricken village of Santa Pancha, Nicaragua. These families can barely meet their basic food, water, and housing needs. We are transforming that village. Be a part of this miracle. I want you to go to the website now and learn how you can help. Go to kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha. There you can join with other warriors against poverty and help bring a miraculous transformation to Santa Pancha. That's kingsransom.org, kingsransom.org.
If you knew you couldn't fail, what would you do with your life? Discover your own answer. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
It is very clear that this survey that was done by American Express saying that people would pay more money for better service. In fact, they'll pay 13% more for better service. The same survey by American Express exposed that 60% of Americans believe that the businesses are putting no focus on service. We just finished hearing a story from Jenny, a faithful listener to the Dani Johnson Show from South Dakota, telling us this terrible Dish Network, awful, disastrous, exasperating customer service experience. Now, why are we talking about that today? Because you might be one that produces terrible service for people and you can't figure out why you can't keep a job or you can't figure out how come your business isn't growing. People want good service. We all do. Every single one of us want good service and we'll pay more money for the better service. Think about this. I challenged a bunch of my business clients a couple of years ago to do this test. I challenged them to go find a Ritz-Carlton and I want you to pull up in it. I don't want you to put a suit on or anything like that because celebrities come into a Ritz-Carlton, which is a very high-end opulent hotel, and they come in their ripped up jeans, their ball caps, and their dirty t-shirts. So you're not judged by what you're wearing at a Ritz-Carlton. So you come into that Ritz-Carlton and you're gonna notice something. You're gonna notice a crazy profound level of service that is being offered to you. They remember your name. They pay attention to the things that you like. They start up conversation with you. They treat you like you are a movie star. They treat you like a celebrity. They treat you like you're some multimillionaire just by association, by just coming in there. The kind of service that they offer you is outstanding. You know, it's very similar, and I'm not saying that Zappos gives you that kind of service or Amazon.com gives you that kind of service, but I can tell you that they make it a point not to exasperate the customer. And they follow this line of thinking that the customer is always right. The customer is always right. Well, in the case with Jenny and Dish Network, the customer is always wrong. For 2 years, she's battling to try to get $287 off of her credit report, something that should have never gone there to begin with, something that she actually paid, had proof that she paid. She even had to hire an attorney to fight this thing. Ugh, that stuff is like shocking. And here, this is hilarious. I remember many years ago that somebody kind of challenged me, not consciously, but subconsciously, to walk into high-end places like a Mercedes dealership versus a used car lot. You see the difference between how you're treated. It's no small wonder that the guys that sell used Mercedes make more money than the guys who sell used Toyotas or Hondas or Hyundais or something like that. You will not find on the breath of a salesman in a Mercedes dealership, you're not going to find last night's whiskey or last night's cheap light beer on their breath. You are not going to smell cigarette smoke on them. You're not going to see dirt on their clothes, and you're certainly not going to see dandruff on their coat lapel. But you will find these things more often in a used car lot that sells lesser kind of vehicles. And why? It's all in how these places carry themselves, the kind of service in which they bring, the value they bring out there into the marketplace. If used car lots actually forbid the people that worked for them to smell like last night's whiskey or their cheap beer or their Camel cigarettes, it would be amazing how many more cars they would actually sell. If they taught their employees to bring great value and bring Ritz-Carlton service out there to that car lot, I promise you that car lot would be so much more successful. But because they've lowered their standards, they have a lower level of customer that comes in, and therefore they don't have a lot of client loyalty. People are looking for good service, and good service means treat them like they are a celebrity. Treat every person that walks through that door, every person that is on the phone, as though they are the president of the United States. Pour out that red carpet to everybody, no matter what they are calling for. When you treat people like that, they want to continue to do business with you. When you treat them with exasperating conversation, like arguing with the customer, when you tell them you can't help them or no, they can't do that or no, they can't have that, and you come right out and say, no, I can't do that. No, I'm sorry, I can't do that. There's another way to say no without the person feeling like they've been told no. There's always ways to communicate where it does not provoke an argument or frustration or anger or even exasperation from our clients. There is a way to honor them, to treat them as though they are very important to you, to love them, to make them feel set apart, to make them feel like they're the only one that matters in that moment of that conversation. And when you do that, now here come referrals. Now here comes a satisfied client that may even make a post on Facebook about how great the service was and how much they love working with your company. It's not that difficult to get referrals. It's not that difficult to build a good reputation. You at least just got to put some elbow grease into it. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
What multimillionaire do you know that volunteers their time to help ordinary people like you and me? There's only one. Stay right here for more of The Dani Johnson Show.
I just heard this amazing story. One of our clients had written us telling us that they had used job domination and unlimited success and has absolutely exploded their career. He said, "Dani, I don't know where I'd be today without job domination and unlimited success. Listen, do you want more recognition from your coworkers? Do you want to be recommended to people all over the world? Do you want to be somebody that is highly sought after? Listen, if you're in a dead-end place where this gentleman found himself but then learned new strategies and changed everything in his work life, and obviously this has resulted in higher bonuses and pay raises, you're next. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Job Domination right now. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Job domination. That's what you need. It's time for you to dominate the job market and break through the rut that you're in.
This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Are people bailing on making a purchase with you because of bad service? Well, recently, an American Express survey proved that 80% of Americans say they have bailed on a transaction because of poor service. You could be missing out on all kinds of money that is just sitting there on the table. Somebody actually came to you, wanted it, left because they didn't like the service. That goes for your website and that goes for your brick and mortar store. Okay, check out this statement by someone who has a crazy amount of success. "We see our customers as invited guests to a party and we are the host. It is our job every day to make every important aspect of the customer service experience a little bit better." That's Jeff Bezos. Yes. The founder of Amazon.com, my second favorite place to make purchases for birthdays or whatever the needs are around, because I can't stand going to the store. That hunting and searching for something drives me crazy. Online, yes, got it in, out, done. In fact, just a couple days ago, I realized that my grandson was about to turn 3. I was like, you know, it was 11 o'clock at night. Where did I go? Amazon.com. Bam, click add to cart for $20. He's got a nice little transforming car that lights up and makes all kinds of noise. Getting back at my daughter. I'm kidding. Anyway, but it's in his hands today on his birthday. Okay, so why do I like Amazon.com? Awesome service. An awesome service experience. They create a way that makes me want to purchase from them. You can learn from these guys. We need to learn from these guys. And I love what he said, and I'm learning right now, that we make it a point, first of all, to treat every single customer as a guest, and we are the host, and we try to make our customer service experience a little bit better every single day. What are you doing to make the experience for your clients better every day? And I don't care if you're a stay-at-home mom. You provide a service for your spouse and your children. What are you doing to provide better service as the mother and the wife of the household to those that you are serving every single day? We can learn from this. And not only that, but we're training up the next generation as mothers to be service-oriented. That's raising up servant leadership. And man, is that powerful. Those kids will succeed greatly because of the example that mom is setting in the house of great service every single day. All right, we're going over the phones. We're talking about good and bad customer service experiences. We've got Christina Loveday. What a great name to have. She's calling in from Newport, Tennessee. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show.
Hi.
So what is your customer service experience that we can be learning from?
I'm going to share a good experience. A couple years back, me and my husband lived in Middle Tennessee near Nashville, and we were new to the town, and I asked a girl that I was working with where I could get my hair done at. And she recommended this lady, and I went in, loved my hair. It was great. made another appointment for 4 weeks out. And when I went in, she knew my name. She knew where I had just moved from. I couldn't even remember things about her, but she knew things we talked about last time. She knew exactly what colors she put in my hair and how I wanted it cut. And at first, I just thought she was amazing at her job. And maybe on my second or third visit, I noticed she had 3x5 cards laid out with her customer's name and notes that she took, you know, for each customer. And I didn't leave thinking, oh, well, she really doesn't care about me. I left thinking she takes her job seriously.
Yeah.
And I gave her referral after referral because I knew that she took her job seriously and she took my hair seriously.
Mm-hmm.
And I own my own business and I learned a lot just from that lady and how she treated me and how she took interest in my life and wanted to know her customers and keep us happy. And I just thought that was amazing.
Yes. My gosh. It's exactly what we teach at First Steps to Success. I wonder if she's a graduate. That's amazing. Because a lot of hairstylists don't do that. The biggest mistake that hairstylists make is they spend that entire 20 minutes or an hour or 2 or 3 hours talking about themselves. Instead of, they do. They go, blah, 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 or they ignore the person in their chair. And they're talking to other stylists, gossiping about who knows what, who's sleeping with who, you know, what J-Lo wore at the whatever the awards were. You know what I mean? They're just like, rah, 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 just talking about nothing. And yet they've got this prized possession in their chair that they should be treating as a guest. That they should be treating as though they have a celebrity. Like, really, if J-Lo was sitting in their chair, would they be gossiping to other hairstylists about something else? No.
No way.
No way. But if they treated every single person that sat in that chair as though they were a high-class celebrity, how they would treat that person, and some people wouldn't treat that person any different, which I think is wise, but give everybody that kind of service. And then here comes the referrals. Good service is the key to referrals. And referrals will build a business no matter what is happening in the economy. No matter what.
Yeah.
No matter what. That business will be sustained because of how we treat the client. And as long as every person that comes into our presence, that we're doing what this woman did, which is so wise, right? And she had a card there to not only write down what color she used on you. That's smart. There's so many hairstylists that don't even do that. And then, you know, we wound up with checkerboards the second time you go through and then the third time. And then they forget it. You ain't going back. But the fact that she wrote down what you guys talked about was really, really wise. I would take it one step further and write a thank you card. Every single person that sits in that chair should get a handwritten thank you card. Now that would take it to home. So think about it. If you ended up getting home a couple days later and you got a handwritten thank you card from that woman, what would that cause you to do?
I'd take a picture of it and put it on Instagram.
And think about it, right?
Because
yes, it would be a shock. Now that would be outstanding and that would make her stand out from everybody else in the area that does hair. Now watch this. It would have gotten referrals to her faster because you waited 4 or 6 weeks to see her, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you didn't know that she took her job seriously until you saw her the second time. You didn't know that she cared about you and remembered all of these things about you until you saw her 6 weeks later. She could have started the process of referrals on day 2 of meeting you by simply sending you a thank you card.
Amazing.
Yes. Those are simple things. How long does it take to write a thank you card, right? Think about it. What would it have said? Christina, thank you so much for choosing me today. I so enjoyed getting to know you. I'm so looking forward to you being in the area, getting to know you better. You know, I really love your desire for your hair, and it obviously you take really good care of yourself, and I'm so looking forward to building a relationship with you for the long haul. Thanks so much for coming in today. I'm looking forward to seeing you on May 2nd at 3:00 for our next appointment. That would have blown your mind. And as you said, I would have taken a picture of it and put it on Instagram. Free advertising.
Yep.
Free advertising. So it's not only the referral, She would have got free advertising out of it by simply writing a thank you card. Why? No one expects them anymore. And then, of course, Christina, there's always the people. Let me ask you this. Do you think it would have been the same if she sent you an email?
No, because I think a card, like you're saying, is more personal, and it took time for her to write. And in today's day and age, an email could just be something they have automatically, like, copied and pasted and just sent out. So a handwritten note is much better.
Yeah. And not only that, but do you get a lot of email already?
Oh, I have 1,300 in my inbox right now. I can't keep up.
Exactly. So answer me this. So an email that says thank you, is that really a thank you, or is that now 1,301 emails that I have to get to?
Yeah, that exactly. It's more of a nuisance.
Exactly. It's a nuisance and a burden. It is not a thank you. It's a nuisance and a burden. It's so funny because I teach this about sending thank you cards. Every time I teach at First Step Success, which is business, finance, and relationship training, there's always a question comes up like, I'm going to do it better. I'm going to send an email. You have fun with that. You're not going to get the same results with an email as you would a handwritten card because people just don't get those anymore. So that thing stands out completely, and it takes not even 60 seconds to write out a thank you card. It's so simple. Christina, thank you for sharing, because that is just textbook. I mean, that is clearly what we write and what we teach in First Steps to Wealth. I mean, I'm telling you, it's textbook of producing really good service. And like I said, one more step would have started the referral process happening even faster. It's so powerful, so simple. You know, we don't have to do anything really sexy and flashy and big. It's as simple as a cheap little thank you card that shows people, wow, I really like this person. This person stands out. It creates the overall experience for that customer that gives them an overall better feeling about the brand and ties them in, you know, brings them back and starts to begin the loyalty. Because again, people are loyal to people. They are not loyal to products. I love my job. Anyway, okay, well, Matt, Christina, thank you so much for sharing. And it's so much better of a story. what Jenny shared earlier, oh gosh, it was painful and exasperating. You could just feel the emotion of just wanting to slam the phone down because of somebody just arguing with you or making you mad. Ugh. You know, and there's another one. Man, the president of Dish Network just goes, okay, I'll take it off your credit report. Like, how about send Jenny flowers? How about refund her the $287 that should have never even been charged? How about send her chocolates? How about, like, send a handwritten card and, like, you know, a coupon for something? Like, you should go overboard trying to make that right. So, simple stuff. Simple little tweaks that can make a big difference and help to grow your business. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
Stay right here for more of The Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. The most common question I get usually are from people who are trying to juggle their life. They've got kids. They've got kids who are involved in all kinds of activities. They've got business or their job, finances, trying to get out of debt, plus all their church activities and all the volunteer activities. And they're pulling their hair out going, how do I juggle this all? Man, I once lived just like that until I learned Time Secrets. Time Secrets showed me how to be able to cut my hours from 100 hours a week that I was working down to 20 hours a week and tripled my income as a direct result with what I learned. Time Secrets also showed me how to get my priorities in order, which healed up my marriage. And I became a mother that I want now was proud of versus becoming the mother I didn't want to be. And so if you feel like your world is running around in all kinds of different circles, you can fix that. Call 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880 for Time Secrets.
Straight talk, real answers. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
You are offering service to everyone around you, whether you realize it or not. And it's either going to be good or it's going to be bad. You get to pick which one it is. Well, Dani, what difference does it make? You know, I don't even have a job. What difference does it make? Oh, it makes a big difference. Our service and how we serve people, what kind of customer service we bring to the table, changes everybody's day. Here's a prime example. Just yesterday, we had one of our team members, we call our staff our team. He just celebrated 10 years that he's been with us. His name is Joseph Heisinger. He's been in our financial department for 10 years. And this guy is amazing. You want to talk about a guy who is a servant leader. And he has prospered greatly because of the way that he serves. Now, when he first came to us, we had just started our business, DaniJohnson.com, right out of our home. I literally was doing business consulting at the foot of my bed with this tiny little old sewing machine table that I had painted all by myself. Okay, since then, tens of millions of dollars has come through that particular business. But Joseph first came to us and applied back when we didn't even have a place of business. And he was working for a very successful construction company that was a corporation, actually. They dealt with kind of all the behind-the-scenes part of construction. So he had a good, secure job. I mean, he was very successful there. He was raising a family with three kids. His wife was the homeschooler, homemaker. And yeah, he comes and he says, I want to be a part of this. I will do anything. I will scrub toilets. I will clean the gutters. I will take out the trash. I will rake leaves. I will do anything to be a part of this company. And I'm like, oh, okay. And he found out that his bookkeeping was his profession. And yeah, we probably could use a bookkeeper, but we don't need someone full time at that moment in time. We didn't need that. But he was so hungry and willing to learn, willing to do anything. I'll answer the phones. I will do anything. I just want to be a part of this. He had heard all the testimonies from all of our clients. Every single month, he and his wife were praying for us and praying for our clients. So we would send them the miraculous stories that our clients were having. People that didn't have jobs or were failing in their business that now were making crazy amounts of money, and people's marriages that were being completely restored, and prodigal sons and daughters coming home, and just crazy, miraculous testimonies that our clients would be writing us pretty much almost every single day. And it still happens to this day, whether by email or by phone or on Facebook. We're always getting some kind of testimony from people. So long story short, I interview him at Starbucks. Okay, so we're doing an interview there. And I ask him the question. So what do you like about your current job? And he says, the security. I have great benefits and I have job security. And I'm like, our business is a faith walk, buddy. I didn't say that to him, but he could see that obviously the countenance meant to change. He goes, but Danny, don't let that deter you. I want to be a part of this, and I believe that God has called me to this, and I will do anything to be a part of it. I'm not looking for job security. I'm looking to be a part of this mission that is changing the world. And I said, okay, great. So anyway, he got started, and we actually opened, we moved our business from our home into our barn, and that's where Joseph started. It's been 10 years now. One of the things that we did with him yesterday is that everybody got a chance to speak over him all the great things that we love about him and our working experience with him. And one of the things that came up several times was that he serves, that he truly is a servant leader. He serves with bringing donuts. He serves with bringing cookies. His wife every single month makes a big batch of all kinds of homemade goodies for all the people that have birthdays that month. And pretty much I think we have birthdays every month, so people are pretty happy about that. But he serves. He also sprinkles in some laughter, and so he's a bit of a prankster also. Always encouraging people. And what's so interesting is that when I brought a message last year to our staff about Ritz-Carlton service, he sends me this email and he says, if all of us treated each other as though we were customers, our coworkers are our customers. My head about exploded. I was like, dude, that is so good. That is so, so good. And then that revelation then grew into, wait a second, I should be bringing Ritz-Carlton service to my husband, to my kids. Now, I do that, and I've done that for years, but it challenged me to go a little bit more. How can I make that even better, to bring even better service to my family than what I'm doing right now? So if you truly believe in servant leadership, you're not here to be served, but you want to serve. And those that serve prosper. Guess what I've watched happen to Joseph? Oh, he has prospered greatly. He's making more money than he's ever made in his past careers. Not only that, he's started to accumulate wealth with real estate and properties. He has several properties now that he manages, that he has purchased on his own and collecting incredible rents. He has done such a phenomenal job, and he's been blessed because customer service is his aim. And he's the guy who takes care of the books. He does the finances. And he could simply say, well, customer service doesn't apply to me. But right away when he heard that message, he thought, my coworkers are my customers. and I'm going to give them the best possible service that I can. That's a killer tip that you can take with you, and that's from our guy, Joseph, who's amazing. We've got Sarah on the phone from Madison, Wisconsin, here to share again. We're studying good customer service models so that we can take that into the home, take that to work, and apply it so that we can bring better value to both places. So, Sarah, welcome to the show, and I'm looking forward to hearing your good customer service story.
Well, just kind of a quick background. I work for surgeons, and we actually offer this program that is we offer it in so they don't have to have surgery and have medication, et cetera.
Mm-hmm.
So most of the time it's not included, you know, paid for by insurance. So we offer a service to help our patients, you know, like kind of navigate the insurance process. And so typically when it gets to my desk, I get the difficult task of dealing with it when it's at its worst. So
right.
I was already beyond frustrated, like 2 months of being put on hold of horrible customer service. And I got to this guy at this insurance company, and I kind of told him the situation. And typically as soon as I speak and I use one word, they're like, oh, you need to go to this department, and they transfer me over. And this guy's like, oh, I know if I transfer you over, they're just going to send you back to this company that's already, this is really complicated. I'm going to try to get into it. He's like, I'm going to fight this. I was like, oh my goodness, I just told him right away, you are the best person ever that you're not just hearing something out of my mouth and putting me and transferring me off of your plate. You're actually looking into this situation. And so he looks into it, researches it, puts me on hold. He's so apologetic, saying, I'm so sorry, I just need a few moments. And he's just like, I was like, no, take your time. That's fine. I'm like, you can do whatever you want, you know? And he's like, I'm going to call over to this other company. I had already called like 3 or 4 times before. And he's like, I'm going to put you on hold. And I was like, you're going to put me on hold? And he's like, why? Do you want to call? I was like, oh, no, go right ahead. You go ahead and you put me on hold. I'll wait all day. I'm like, I'm fine with that. And he puts me on hold. And he's like, I should get there real quick. So just one moment. And I was on the phone for an hour on hold. So he was on hold for an hour, and he kept checking in. He's like, I'm so sorry, I don't know what's taking so long. And I was like, no, it's fine, I'm just chilling, I'm getting other work done, it's fine.
Wow.
You know, take your time, I really appreciate it. And he went ahead and got the answer, and he came back to me. It was not exactly what I wanted to hear. But I said, you know what, Kyle, I was like, and he was totally understanding. I was explaining on behalf of the patient. I said, you know, just all the frustration. He just listened. And he was just like, I understand. And I said, you know what, Kyle? I said, this is not how I wanted to turn out, but I honestly want to talk to your supervisor.
Yeah.
Tell him how amazing you have been.
Yep. Yep.
And he's like, oh my God, I would just love that.
And that's what happens. That's what happens. It's like he was performing for something so much higher and bigger and didn't even know that he was. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
Don't go away. The next segment might just change your life. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
The whole story of how I went from homeless to millions is right here in this book, First Steps to Wealth. I'd love to give you a free copy of this book. Just dial 888-757-8880. You can get your free copy of this book. It's like a real book, my friend. You can get an ebook copy for free right now, or if you'd like to pay the shipping to get this $15 book to your house, I'd be happy to send it to you. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of First Steps to Wealth today and begin on a brand new path of some great success.
Be sure to tell a friend about the Dani Johnson Show. It just might be the key to the breakthrough they need. And now, back to the Dani Johnson Show.
You know what? We are on an audition every day. And every day we have the opportunity to audition for something better and greater when we know it. This is exactly what Sarah was just talking about. She had an amazing customer service experience. It actually didn't turn out great, but it turned out great for the customer service rep. So Sarah, here, because this guy handled you with such gentleness, such care, he treated you like a human. He didn't treat you like you were a nuisance. He didn't treat you like you were a waste of his time, that you were a pain in his backside. So because he treated you with such care with everything that he was doing, even though the answer that he delivered to you was not the one that you wanted, you still were happy with the service. And that's what all of us need to do. That's the bottom line. And so you ended up calling his supervisor and bragging on him.
Yep. I basically said, you know, Kyle, he's like, I would love that. And I was like, go ahead. Yep. I said, I want to talk to your supervisor. Yeah. That means you have to put me on hold and transfer me over to her. And so he did. And I talked to his supervisor and I said, I just want to tell you how amazing Kyle has been. He has been the best customer service rep I've ever talked to at an insurance company.
Wow.
And I'm telling you, I talk to a lot of people at large corporations and I deal with very difficult, complicated situations. And he is the best person I've ever talked to. And I said, he saw it on behalf of me as the customer and our patient.
Wow.
I said, this is not how I wanted it to turn out, but I'm just telling you, he is so amazing. I mean, I can't stop thinking about this guy and the service that he provided me. And he told me no, and I don't like no. I'm just like.
But look at how awesome that is. So even when we have to deliver an answer we know the customer is not looking for, it's all on how we do it. And there's no question that guy should be, in fact, I'd like to know who he is, what his phone number is. I'd like to hire him. The bottom line is that he's going to get promoted up. Who knows? He might even manage an entire call center one day because of that kind of service that he provided. Wow. That's amazing, Sarah. Thank you so much for sharing that. We needed to hear that, especially from the other side of it, that somebody else needs to know that if they're treating people right, that's going to create more opportunity for them. Speaking of which, we would love to give you a free copy of this book so that you can help add more value to your career. It's First Steps to Wealth, absolutely free. No gimmicks, no joke, no nothing. But what we've been talking about today is one of the chapters inside of this book, one of the skill sets that we teach so that you can raise your value. And you raise your value in the marketplace, you're going to raise your pay. That is First Steps to Wealth. Call the phone number, 866-760-8255. Again, that's 866-760-8255. Ask for Stephen or Nate. Both of these gentlemen are happy to serve you immediately. And if you want the ebook, it's free to your inbox right now. If you'd like the physical copy, you want to write in the margins, you want to highlight, you want to dog ear it, you're like physical like I am, simply just pay the shipping and handling, get your free copy today. This is Dani Johnson. Thanks so much for joining us. Have a great rest of the day. God bless.
Did you hear that last segment? Do you know someone else who needs to hear it? Go to DaniJohnson.com, find today's show, and share it online. Join us every weekday at 7 a.m. for more insights that will help you get to the life you've always wanted. Did you know you can see Dani Johnson live and in person? Go to DaniJohnson.com and find out about our next live event. First Steps to Success, register today. Call 866-760-8255 or go to DaniJohnson.com/FSTS.